HTC Sense 5 screenshots emerge, Nokia to rebrand PureView for their smartphone cameras, and leaked Samsung roadmaps underwhelm. I'm Jaime Rivera. On a diet for 30 minutes from coffee, this is Pocket Now Daily. Analysts are always filling our days with numbers, and such is the case of the recent reports that confirm which is the most used operating system in the US market. Drumroll, if you thought this was Android, you'll sadly be disappointed because apparently iOS is being used by 51% of the market. And it just begs to wonder, since recently LG took the crown as the second smartphone manufacturer in the United States, taking the crown from the iPhone, so which number should we believe? And speaking of iOS, for those of you that didn't know that there's a backstory behind Siri, well, there actually is. From its origins as a military project to the fact that you could later download it from the App Store as a simple app service that you could use, well, the rest is history as Apple bought the company eventually. But did you really know that Verizon was actually in line to buy the service at some point? And the purpose was to install it on every Droid in the market. But for those of you that remember, Siri wasn't actually working on Android as it was working on the iPhone. So the rest is history for now. It just begs to wonder if Apple wouldn't have been better off without Siri. I actually do enjoy it, but I don't know about you. And for those of you that were left drooling over the Galaxy Note 8 rumors that we published yesterday, well, we're sad to disappoint that there's a leaked roadmap that shows that the device will be just another Android tablet with Galaxy Note capabilities. There's really nothing special about this tablet aside from the fact that it will have the adequate size for a Galaxy Note device, meaning you won't be getting the Exynos 5 Octa processor in this device at least. We were thinking that all Galaxy devices in 2013 were going to sport this new processor, but apparently this device is not going to include it, so we'll keep you posted. Most likely MWC will be the day where we will know more about this device. And for those of you diehard fans of the Nokia 808 PureView and the concept of a better camera on the smartphone, that was later trashed as a brand with the Lumia 920 and the fake ad debacle, it seems that Nokia is already working on actually rebranding the real 808 PureView as a concept, or at least the 42 megapixel camera. Now the interesting point here is that these unconfirmed sources are saying that it will be called Nokia EOS. And for those of you that know EOS, well, that's the same branding that Canon uses in their DSLR cameras, like the one that we're using to film this video. The question is, when will we be getting this new Nokia EOS rebrand? And will we be getting that same 42 megapixel camera on smaller smartphones like the Lumia branding? We'll keep you posted on that. And finally, for the hot news of the day, recent leaked images of the HTC M7 also brought leaked images of HTC Sense 5.0. And to be honest with you, there's a lot to look forward here. I mean, it looks a lot more minimalistic and less fluffy than previous versions of Sense, and it begs to wonder if HTC just wants to work on making everything more efficient and less, again, fluffy. So that leads me to the question of the day. What are you expecting from Sense 5.0? Would you prefer more fluff or less fluff? In our particular case, we just want something that works well and that launches fast, and hopefully HTC Sense 5.0 will bring that to the table. So leave us a comment down below and we'll keep you posted at MWC 2013. And if you want an earlier scoop of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tablet world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks for watching and stay tuned tomorrow. For those of you that loved our hangout last week, we're going to film our second hangout tomorrow at 2 p.m. Eastern time. And we're going to be calling this Pocket Now Live from now on, where you'll be able to interact with us and ask us questions or just have fun with us as we talk about different things, not necessarily only tech. See you tomorrow.